Hello everyone, welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. Today we'll be diving into an application called CLARO Today, and it's a to-do list application that was apparently rated in the top 10 startups to watch of 2019 in beta list. And also it is an application that many people are talking about. Apparently users from Airtable, WeTransfer, Ring and Yelp use it, but it's a very simple one at that. We'll be taking a look at why it's $5 per month and also all of the features that you need to know in this application. Anyway, folks, let's dive into today's video. So I have paid the $5 for the month, and as you can imagine, I'm going to give you my opinion. Hopefully near the end, I'll point towards whether it is worth $5 per month and obviously compare it to something that is fairly similar to some extent. Now, recently I've seen a rise in these sort of applications, clean interfaces with your sort of next 5 days in front of them, sort of like a blend between a calendar to some extent, but almost like this very simple sort of task list in front of you. And it's something that we actually reviewed in an application called Checklists, which actually will be, I'll reference in the cards above. But as you can see, this is CLARO. So it is a very minimalist way to start adding your tasks. As I said, it's a task manager at heart. So let's start adding some tasks for Monday. Now, Monday is an Easter Monday. So obviously it will be a day off. So I can use a highlight tool over on this left-hand side to be able to highlight that in a green color. Actually, yellow is more Easter. And all I have to do is press Easter in that highlight color, and as you can see, it appears there. So that's how to add a highlight, and that's how to get rid of it. So that's particularly useful for prioritizing tasks and just being able to, and as you can imagine, just being able to start bringing them out. But if I wanted to add a very basic task, so for example, book home delivery for shop, as you can see here, that's how I would add a task. And if I press enter, it gets added to the day. Now I can do something, I can star it here, which does again bring the priority out. So that's maybe if you wanted to highlight it even further, maybe I wanted to do that there and make it even more clear. But the only things you can do with the task is copy it or delete it. And the only other thing you can do as well is drag it to another day. So as you can see, it's been moved to the next day. You can undo that task if you want to. Now, that's really all it can do to some extent. It doesn't have a mobile application at the moment. It doesn't have any recurring tasks. So if, for example, I wanted to add take bins out to Wednesday, which I normally do it, I can't make that a recurring task, which is a bit of a pain. And I can't view it on mobile either. But as you can imagine, with time, I'm sure they'll add that update. And they look like they had it on their roadmap. So that is good news. Now, as you can see here, it's very simple. Now, if you compare it to something like To-Do, which we did a feature on recently, Matt Diavella's chosen task management application, you can see that with the lists down here and also the sort of week view coming up. Although To-Do is less minimal than this other application, definitely packs more of a punch, allowing you to add recurring to-dos, etc., very easily. Now, as you can imagine, this is a fairly new space to some extent. This application's been around for a while, but this new tool, CLARO, has actually been out for not even a few weeks, and it's actually still in early access, so you won't actually get access to it. But the difference is, this, if you go to subscription, is $3 a month, not $5. $5 is quite a hefty application. If we go back and we go on CLARO, so I obviously paid $5 a month for this. So comparing that to $3 with an application that's been around a lot longer, just for the minimalist style, it's pretty much nothing too special in terms of getting an additional bonus. So although I like the design of this application, I think the price is really out of whack. I'd be more than happy to pay in the range of $2 for something like this if I was looking for a to-do list application, but definitely not $5. $5 is the price of Notion. Notion does an incredibly lot more than this, and looks much better in my opinion. But as you can imagine, early days for this application. I'm not sure why they're pricing it so highly now at this price. I'm just really emphasizing on this just because I think they need to tone it down on the price. I think it's definitely, there's, as I said in an article recently, there will be an application where we pay a lot more per month, and I'm concerned whether this might be it if the prices continue to rise in the future. Now, as you can see here, box is essentially your inbox. So there is a little bit of difference between, say, this and the other to-do. You can store stuff in an inbox. So, for example, I could say clear email, plan, map out route to park. You can see here that two items have been added there, and I can actually go out of this and back in, and I can drag stuff very easily there. So if I wanted to be able to move stuff from the inbox to there, so that's quite a helpful feature, but doesn't quite have the list abilities that To-Do has. So as you can see, it's a very attractive application, there's no doubt about that. It has some value. The inbox is cool, the design is cool, the highlights are cool, it's got some cool features, but the price is not cool. Definitely look to reduce it down to $2 a month, I think would be a much more suitable price at the moment. And then when features are added, it could then be looking more like the other application. Even the checklist application that I reviewed isn't priced at the moment, but obviously early days for that. And this is still early days, so there's no excuse to be pricing it at this price. You can see I'm a bit more passionate about this one. As I said, a good experience in terms of what it can do, but definitely not the price. Anyway, folks, I'll include the secret link to this. I did check it out, and it was something that caught my eye, but definitely not something that I'm going to hold back on. Anyway, folks, do check it out. Obviously, let me know your thoughts on it in the comments below. If you're new here, subscribe, and look forward to hearing from you and hearing some of your thoughts on Claro. Anyway, guys, thank you so much. I will talk to you all very, very soon. Cheers, everyone. Bye.